A very refreshing good morning to all of you. So this is my second video of the chapter Getting to Know Plants. Okay, so I hope you all have seen the first video. So if you remember, in our first video we have discussed about different kinds of the plant on the basis of their characteristics. Then we have started with the function of different parts of the plant, isn't it? So function of different parts of the plant we have started, and first part we have taken, that was our stem, isn't it? So what is the function of the stem? First of all, what is a stem? You know, it is the part of the plant which bears flowers. That means flower is also attached to stem, branches are also attached to stem, leaves are also attached to the stem. So stem is the part of the plant which bear other parts of the plant like flowers, fruits, leaves, buds, etc. So what is the function of stem? What is the function of stem? It helps in the upward movement of water and minerals. Again, I am taking this topic, children. It helps in the upward movement of water and minerals. So this is the function of stem. Okay, so upward movement, helps in upward movement also. And it helps in downward movement also. About this we will study later on. But first I will tell you, like the stems helps in the upward movement of water and minerals. That means it takes water and minerals to other parts of the plants. Okay. So this we have studied with the help of one activity. Okay. What was that activity? We will take one glass. We will take water. Water we will take. Then we will add red or blue ink. Okay. We are adding red color to it. So that the water now, it is of which color? It is of red color. Now what we will do? We will take the stem. This is a stem. We will take this, this is a stem, we will take the stem of any plant and we will immerse this in water. We will cut the base of the stem and then we will immerse it in water so that in a better way the water will move in which direction? In up direction. Okay, so like this is a stem. So it will be very interesting if you will take a stem which bears, for example, white flowers. For example, this is our white flower. Okay. You will keep it for some time and afterwards you will observe that. Afterwards you will observe that this water minerals will start moving in upward direction. This water will start moving in which direction? In up direction. This can be proved if the color, this can be proved in this way. Like if the color of the flower is white in color, so you can see the red color impression on the white flower. That means the white flower will start changing into light color pink flower. You can see it. Okay, this is only due to the upward movement of water. Again, you can do one thing to check. You take this stem outside and you will, if you will cut this stem, you will see the red color in the veins of the stem. Okay, so this activity proves that stems help in the upward movement of water and minerals. Understood, children? Very easy. Again, I am repeating this. Glass lenge. पानी लेंगे, इसमें रेड कलर की इंक डालेंगे, ताकि क्या हो जाए, ये वॉटर क्या हो जाए, किस कलर का हो जाए, रेड कलर का हो जाए। फिर इसमें हम क्या करेंगे, कोई भी स्टेम लेंगे किसी भी प्लांट का और उसका नीचे से उसका बेस हम कट करके फिर इसको इमर्स कर देंगे, ठीक है। उसके बाद आप क्या, उसके बाद उसको ऐसे ही बहुत देर के लिए, हम कुछ देर के लिए इसको ऐसे ही रख देंगे। उसके बाद क्या होगा कि जब हम स्टेम इसको लेंगे और स्टेम को कट करेंगे तो हम देखेंगे कि उसके वेन्स में रेड रेड कलर का स्पॉट आ रहा है। दैट मीन्स वो रेड कलर का स्पॉट कहां से आया है, दैट रेड स्पॉट इज ओनली ड्यू टू द अपवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ दिस रेड कलर वॉटर। क्लियर, अंडरस्टूड? आई होप यू ऑल हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस। नाउ दिस इज अबाउट स्टेम, ओके। नाउ नेक्स्ट विल स्टडी अबाउट लीव्स। नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट लीव्स। स्टेम वी हैव टेकन, दिस इज द नेक्स्ट वन लीव। लीव आई थिंक यू ऑल नो अबाउट लीव, इजंट इट? सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द लीव, है ना। वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लीव, हाउ डज इट लुक लाइक, व्हाट आर द पार्ट्स ऑफ द लीव, है ना। And then we will study about the functions of the leaf also. We will study about the functions of the leaf. You know now what is leaf? How does it look like? This is a leaf, isn't it? Okay. So, in a leaf, this is a diagram of leaf. Okay. First of all, one by one we will take each and every parts of leaf. Okay. So till here it's leaf, and this is our stem. This is our stem. Okay. So this part of the leaf is attached to the stem of the leaf, to the stem of the plant. This part of leaf is attached to the stem of the plant. So this part of leaf is known as what? Petiole. This part of the leaf is known as what? Petiole. Then next, this broader part of the leaf, this broader part of the leaf is known as what? Lamina. This broad part of the leaf is known as what? Lamina. So clear? Petiole, the part of the leaf which is attached to the stem. Next is this broader part of the leaf is known as lamina. Also, now we are going to study about like veins. What are veins? What are veins? The lines that you are observing in the leaves. These lines are there, na? The lines, like various shape. This lines on the leaf is known as what? Veins of the leaf. So these are known as what? Veins of the leaf. Clear? The design that's there, that is known as what? Veins of the leaf. Okay. And the center, this broader part leaf, the middle part is very, very broad. It's very, very visible to us. It's bold, isn't it? So this middle part of the leaf, this prominent part of the leaf, this is known as what? Midrib. This is known as what? Midrib. Clear? Petiole, lamina. The lines that is there on the leaf, that is known as what? Veins of the leaf. And central part of the leaf, that is known as what? That is known as what? Midrib. Okay. Now we will study about leaf venation. Now we will study about leaf venation. Leaf venation is veins, you know, The lines that is there on the leaf, that is known as what? Veins. Now, leaf venation is the design made by veins on leaf. Designs made by vein on leaf is known as leaf venation. The design that is made by the veins on the leaf, that is known as what? Leaf venation. Clear? है ना? अलग अलग तरीके के डिजाइन होते हैं लीव में, वेन्स के अलग अलग तरीके डिजाइन होते हैं, ठीक है? सो डिजाइन मेड बाय वेन्स ऑन द लीफ इज नोन एज व्हाट? लीव वेनेशन. नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट, देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ लीव वेनेशन. रेटिकुलेट वेनेशन and parallel venation. Okay, there are two types of designs that is made on the leaf. Okay, one is two types of leaf venation. One is reticulate venation, and next one is parallel venation. Reticulate and parallel venation. So, what is reticulate venation? If, listen carefully, if veins are arranged in the leaf in the form of net-like structure, or we can say web-like structure, that is known as our reticulate venation. है ना? अगर नेट लाइक है या फिर वेब टाइप है, मतलब दिस टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज व्हाट? दिस टाइप ऑफ डिजाइन दैट इज मेड बाय लीफ इज नोन एज व्हाट? रेटिकुलेट वेनेशन. पैरेलल वेनेशन, एज अ नेम इटसेल्फ इट्स वेरी क्लियर. इफ वेन्स आर अरेंज्ड, पैरेलल टू ईच अदर, दैट मीन्स इट इज नोन एज व्हाट? Parallel venation. Okay, net like leaf venation, designs made by veins on the leaf, leaf venation. Reticulate, if the veins are arranged in a net like way, that is known as what? Reticulate. If the veins are arranged parallel to each other, that is known as what? Parallel venation. And I will show you this with the help of diagram also. Okay. Reticulate venation, parallel venation. Okay. So reticulate venation means, see, this is a leaf. Remember na? Petiole, lamina, broad part, central midrib, and veins are the lines that is there on the leaf. If the veins are arranged in a net-like fashion on both sides of midrib, like in this way, okay, this shape of the structure, that is known as what? Reticulate venation. But if the veins are arranged in a parallel way, that is known as what? Parallel venation. Like this, if you can see. This is known as what? Parallel venation. This type of structure you can observe in case of like grass, wheat plant, maize plant, all this have parallel venation. And reticulate venation you can observe in rose plant, tulsi plant, The lines are arranged like parallel to each other, isn't it? Parallel to each other. Parallel venation, reticulate, that means web-like structure, net-like structure, okay? That is known as what? Reticulate venation. I hope you all have understood the structure of leaf, okay, children? So, what all things we have done in the structure of leaf? We have studied about, petiole, we have studied about lamina, we have studied about midrib, we have studied about veins, leaf venation, reticulate venation and parallel venation. Okay, so I think you all have understood it here. In my next video, we will study about the functions of the leaf. Okay, we will study about the functions of leaf. So, please read the chapter till here. Okay, and then I will come with my next video. Thank you, children.